Priya Pasnur, working as an assistant professor in civil department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's class, we are going to discuss the building bylaws. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to impart the knowledge and apply the principles of various bylaws of the building. Bylaws. Actually, the construction of any building, certain restrictions are laid by the municipal bodies, the urban development authorities, and the other government departments as the town planning trusts to clear the open spaces which should be left around the building. Here you can pause the video for 2 minutes and try to give the answer for this. What are the objectives of the building bylaws? This is the answer for that. It allows the disciplined and the systematic growth of the buildings and the towns, and it prevents the haphazard development. It protects the safety of the public against the fire, the noise, the health hazards, and the structural failure. It provides the proper utilization of the space. Hence, maximum efficiency in the planning can be derived from these bylaws. They give guideline to the architect or an engineer in effective planning and useful in the pre-planning the building activities. They also provide the health, the safety, and the comfort to the people who live in the building. These are the bylaws for the different buildings. These are the points which should be considered. The line of the building frontage. Second, we have the open spaces around the residential buildings. Next, we have the minimum standard dimensions of the building elements. Next, the provisions for the lighting and the ventilation. Provision for the safety from the fire and explosion. Provision for the means of the access. Requirements for the green belt and the landscaping. Sizes of the structural elements. Next, the special requirements for low-income group housing. The provision for the drainage and the sanitation. Provision for the safety of the works against the accidents, the hazards. Requirements for the off-street parking space. These are the bylaws which should be considered. So out of that, I will just give an idea of some of the points, like means of the access. Access, it is an approach to a building or a plot. So every building or a plot, it should be given an access, whether it may be a public or a private access. So there are from the street or the road. So the width of the mean of the axis, it is defined on the length of the mean of the axis. For the residential plots, following width of the roads are defined on the width of the mean of the axis, according to the width of the mean of the axis. So if we have a width of the mean of the axis as 6 meters, so in that case, the length of the axis provided will be 75 meters. And if the width of the mean axis is 7.5, so over there the length will be provided as 150 meters. If the width is 9 meter, the length will be 250 meters. Here you can see that if the width is 12 meters, the length will be 400 meters. If the width is 18 meters, it is 1000 meters length. And for a 20 meter width of the main axis, you can see that the length will be above 1000 meters. Next, we have also the pathway. Pathway, the internal, the approach to a building or a plot from the internal mean of the axis. Internal mean of the axis shall be provided from the pathway. So the width of the pathway, it should not be less than 1.5 meters. These are the requirements of the plots, in which we have the size of the plots. So type of the residential building, it will be depending upon the type of the buildings. And this is the plot size and the frontage, how much it should be left. So for a detached building, the plot size will be about 250 meters square and the frontage will be 12 meters. And if you have the semi-detached building, the plot size will be 125 meters square to 250 meters square. Frontage will be 8 to 12 meters. For a row house, the plot size will be around 50 to 125 meters square. Over there, the frontage will be 4.5 to 8 meters. So this is a setback, which is a setback is nothing but the distance which will be left around the building. For a building height above 14 meters, you have the height of the building and the minimum requirement setback, that is the side and the rear margin, and the setback from the road front. So if you have the height of the building above 14 meters and up to 24 meters, you have the side margin to be left as h by 2 minus 4. It will be minimum 3 meters. And the setback from the road front will be 6 meters. If you have the height above 24 meters and up to 37.5 meters, in that case the side and the rear margin will be h by 3. And the setback from the road will be 9 meters. And for a height above 37.5 meters, in that case, the side margin will be h by 3 and the setback will be 12 meters. What are the requirements of the buildings? So the open space around the building, in that we have the exterior open space up to 10 meter height of the building, the front open space. So the front open space which we have, for the 1.5 meter open space, the width of the street fronting the plot will be 7.5, and if the front open space is 3 meters, in that case you have the width of the street as 7.5 to 18 meters. And if the front open space is 4.5 meter, in that case the width of the street will be 18 to 30 meters. And for 6 meter, it will be width will be above 30 meters. Every room or a unit intended for the human habitation shall have an interior or an exterior open space. Maybe it may be a veranda also. So likewise, you have the space which should be left. So accordingly, we have the height, side and the rear margins which should be left around the building. So if a height of a building is 10 meters, in that case the side margin and the rear margin will be 3 meters, which should be open space to be left around the building. So likewise, we have the height, we have the table for the height of the building and the side and the rear margin to be left around the building. So even the parking space, we have some of the limitations as what space to be left. The space to be left for the Hof Street parking are as follows. For a car, the minimum parking space to be left is 3 meter by 6 meter when the individual parking is required, and 2.5 by 5 meter when the common parking is required. That means when the parking, when it may be a public space where number of cars may be parked, in that case the space will be limited. So in that case you can go for the 2.5 by 5 meter space. And for the scooters, motorcycles, the area should not be less than 1.25 meter square. And for bicycle, it may be 1 meter square. For area of each individual car space, inclusive of the circulation, it is 23 meter square for the open parking, 28 meter square for the ground floor covered parking, and 32 meter square for the basement. Likewise, we have the parking space which should be available. These are the references which I have referred. Thank you.